In this demonstration, I'm going to show an example of how to configure a virtual tape library on a DXi system and integrate it with a backup application. We're going to use a DXi 6800 system as the virtual tape library for this demo, but the process is the same for other DXi models with 2.2.x software that support VTL. We will use Symantec NetBackup 7.5 to integrate with the VTL and manually backup some data. The process that I'm going to demonstrate is documented in the DXi User's Guides, which are available on the Quantum website support page that relates to your DXi model. To access documentation for your DXi product, use a web browser to go to quantum.com. Select Support. Select your specific DXi product. And then select the Documentation tab. The Virtual Tape Library presentation allows you to configure one or more virtual libraries, along with a number of virtual tape drives. A VTL has the same components as a physical library. It will consist of drives, bins or slots, media, and a changer or robot. The backup application sees these virtual components as physical components. To SAN components such as Fabric, HBAs, host OSs, and backup applications, the DXi VTL looks the same as a physical tape library. Now let's go over the main steps for configuring VTL. First, there are some tasks that need to be performed on the DXi system. And then some additional tasks need to be done on the NetBackup server. These steps will be different for other backup applications. Let's start by logging into our DXi 6800. Our first step will be to add a VTL partition. We'll do that by clicking on Configuration, VTL, and then under the Partitions and Summary tabs, we'll click Add. First, we need to give our VTL partition a name. We'll call it Test VTL. For the library model, we'll select Quantum Scalar i6000. Then, for the number of storage slots, we'll enter 100. For the virtual tape drive model, we'll go with the IBM LTO4 drives. And we'll give it 5 tape drives. We'll make sure that we leave Enable Deduplication checked. We want to deduplicate data written to this VTL partition. Then click Apply. When the job status panel indicates job finished, we'll click OK. You can create VTL partitions with a lot of different emulation types and options. We're keeping this pretty basic for this demo. Next, we're going to create some media for this partition. I'm going to click on the Media tab, and under the Add tab, we're going to select our partition test VTL. For the initial location, we'll select storage slot, and then we have the option to specify how many media we're going to create. We created 100 storage slots with our partition so we could create up to 100 pieces of media, but we're only going to do 10 for this demo. We need to give it a starting barcode, and we'll go with AB0001. Then for the media type, we have a couple different options that give us different native sizes. For LTO4, we get 800 gig. Select LTO3, and that gives us a native size of 400 gig. We could also select a custom size, which would allow us to specify a size between 5 gig and the maximum native size of the cartridge that we have selected. We'll go with a smaller custom size of 100 gig in accordance with Quantum's best practices. And click Apply. Now it's created our 10 pieces of media for us. Our next step is to create a host access group that will map an attached host to these VTL devices we just created. Let's click on the Host Access tab, and then under Host Mapping, we're going to add a host group. Before we do that though, let's click on the Host tab and make sure that we do have an attached host. Here you can see one that's active. I've already given it an alias of TrainMBU2, which is the host name of that server. Back under Host Mapping, we'll click Add. Then we'll give it a host group mapping name of TestVTLGroup. We'll want to make sure that we have the correct partition selected. We only have one, so we'll go with TestVTL. We'll make sure that we have our correct host selected, and then for the target, we'll select the appropriate fiber port that we're connected to. We'll select FC1 and make sure that all of the devices that we want to present to this host are selected and have associated LUN numbers. And click Apply. Click Yes to continue setting up our host access group. And now our DXi settings are in place. Now we're ready to move over to our backup server and finish our configuration there. Before proceeding with the backup application configuration, you would want to make sure that the VTL devices are seen by the host operating system and that the device drivers are loaded. These steps will vary depending on your host operating system. From the NetBackup Administration console, we're going to click on the Configure Storage Devices wizard. This will scan for and configure the new robot and drives we just configured and will allow us to create a storage unit. When the wizard opens, click Next. I'll select our Train MBU2 host. It will scan the host for any devices that are attached. I'll click Next to scan. Under the status column, it tells us that it detected 5 tape drive paths and 1 robot. I'll click Next. We don't need to change anything on the SAN clients or backup devices pages, so I'll click Next on both of those. On the drag and drop configuration page, we can open up our robot and see the 5 tape drives associated with that robot. Everything looks good, so let's go ahead and click Next. I'll click Yes to continue and commit the changes. The configuration settings were updated successfully, so I'll click Next again. Now we'll create a storage unit for this tape library. I'll go into the properties for the storage unit and give it a meaningful name.
We named our VTL Test VTL, so sticking with that naming convention, we'll enter that as the storage unit name and click OK.
I'll click Next and then click Finish. Before we can use our newly created storage unit to back up data, we need to perform one more step. If we click on Devices and then on Robots, that shows the robot we just configured. We need to select the robot and right-click, then select Inventory Robot. And then click Start to scan for media within that VTL library. It found the 10 pieces of media we created when we set up the VTL on the DXi-6800. And we can see the barcodes we configured in this column. I'll click Yes to update the volume configuration and then close. Now we're ready to create a policy to use our storage unit and our new devices. I'll click on Policies, right-click, and select New Policy. For the policy name, I'll call it VTL Backup and make sure the box is checked to use the Policy Configuration Wizard, and click OK. When the wizard opens, I'll leave the default selection and click Next. I'll verify my policy name and will use the MS Windows policy type and click Next. For the client, we'll add the name of this server. I'll click Add and enter the name Train MBU2 and then press Tab. The hardware and operating system will autocomplete. Then I'll click Next. We'll specify a folder to backup and click Next. For backup type, frequency and rotation and start window, we'll use the default settings. At the end of the wizard, I'll click Finish. Before we start our manual backup, let's open our VTL backup policies properties and make sure for the policy storage that we've selected our test VTL storage unit. Then I'll click OK. We're now ready to run a manual backup. I'll right-click on the policy VTL backup and select Manual Backup. I'll select a full backup with our Train MBU2 client and click OK. Then I'll acknowledge the start message by clicking OK. We can monitor the progress of our backup by clicking on Activity Monitor. I'll double-click the job to see the detailed status so that we can view the progress. Our backup has completed successfully and we have written data to our new DXi-6800 VTL. In this demonstration, I showed you how to configure a VTL backup and integrate it with a backup application. Always refer to the user's guide that relates to your DXi model for detailed VTL configuration procedures. After you have configured a virtual tape library, you can refer back to the user's guide if you need to make changes to the VTL, such as adding or removing media.